Right, Shalom. Wanna give all praises to Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the apostle, as a great millstone that ruled well. Salutations to all the Achaim around the world, pushing this word in truth and sincerity. Right, I'm Amma One from the Great Millstone Camp, Trinidad. There's no way you could dance around this truth. What the apostle Eleazar Great Millstone said, it have no way that you could find, it are no loopholes. We could get a loophole here or find a loophole. It are no way. It's sealed tight. It how do you describe it? Like something that just sealed. And it can't have no penetration into it. That's how this doctrine is. People just try to come up and debunk it. It's undebunkable. What is the doctrine? America going to be destroyed by thermal nuclear destruction. The so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, beginning with Yahweh Shai, going on rule, Yahweh Shai, who is the son of the living God, who the world ignorantly called Jesus, going on rule the earth in righteousness forever and ever. Two-thirds of Israel going to be destroyed. And all are written in the scriptures. The so-called white man is the devil. Nobody can debunk that out. Who could debunk that the so-called white man is the devil? Look at the works. You understand? Where else? Cornelius is an Israelite. Right? And many other things. This doctrine, hey, the mark of the beast is the RFID microchip. Right now, they can't say nothing against that. Who could come against and say, dine the mark of the beast? The mark of the beast is the RFID microchip. That is where it is. And this doctrine is the truth. You know? This is the truth. You don't know what that truth is either. Yeah, what it is. Matter of fact, let me read the scripture. This is Matthew chapter 16, verse 17. This is dealing with when Yahweh Shai was talking to Peter. Right? He asked Peter, Yahweh Shai asked them, who all this here is? Some say John the Baptist, some say Elijah, some say Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. So Yahweh Shai asked Peter, well, who you think I is? Peter said, well, you use the son of the living God, use the Messiah, Hamashiach, Yahweh Shai. So, verse 17 says, and Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon, Bar-Jonah meaning the son of Jonah, for flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee, that thou art Peter. If you look up the meaning of the word Peter in the Greek, I believe it comes from the word Petros, which means rock, if I'm mistaken. The whole matter, can't remember too vividly. And upon this rock will I build my church, and the gates of hell, here where I was shy telling me, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. What is the gates of hell? You have a great millstone. And everything else is the gates of hell. Because if you ain't coming up, let me just get this precept right real quick. Just now. This John 10 and 10. Book of St. John chapter 10 verse 1. So like here. Verily I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. And die all these false prophets here. You understand? That all these false prophets here, because they don't enter into the door, they want to come up some other way. They want to enter, the door begins with the doctrine what the apostle Eleazar Great Millstone teach. You enter into that door, They go enter into Yahweh Shai, into the ways of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. You understand? You enter into that door. But these men want to climb up some other way. So as I say, you have great millstone. That is that door. That is where it starts. You understand? It begins with that doctrine them teaching is the 100% truth. And then it are the others. But Yahweh Shai say, the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. So when you see great millstone out there, nobody, the beginning with Apostle Elataha, all the way down, the doctrine that great millstone preach, it on debunkable, you can't debunk it. People just tell themselves they debunk it, you can't debunk it because Yahweh Shai say so. He said the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. There are no double standards with great millstone. People might think they see, but they don't. I look it out for myself. Me, I ain't see no double standards. It have great millstone, and the men, it have other men like DTA, who preach the same thing what great millstone preach. That is, it have that one. And then it had the rest. The rest is the gates of hell. Esau and his churches. Nate and the IUIC, which is one of Esau church. GOCC, which is one of Esau church. HODC. All of them fellas and them. They is the gates of hell. Because them don't want to climb in the door. Them don't want to climb in the door and enter into the sheepfold, but they want to climb in some other way. The only way to enter into the sheepfold is by the way of the truth. And the apostle elders are great millstone have 100% of the truth. You understand? They have 100% of the truth. This is 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Chapter 13 verse 8, it says, for we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. So you can do nothing against it. There's nothing you could do against it. You can only do for it. If you scoff, you're scoffing for the truth. If you're in the truth, you're doing it for the truth. And that is how real it is. If you're scoffing against the apostles, you're scoffing, you're doing your part to help the truth in some way. Because that prophecy is that scoffers will come. So you're proving that the scripture is real. In the last days, 2 Peter 3 and around 3, the third verse, that there shall arise in the last days scoffers. So if you're scoffing, and you telling yourself you're doing something against the truth, you actually doing it for the truth. Because you're proving that you're fulfilling prophecy. And we are living in the last days, according to prophecy. You understand? So that is just it. You don't have no way around what you get with apostle, letter, how the way down. Once you stick him with that doctrine, it has no way nobody could debunk it. It have no way nobody could debunk it. If you're trying to come into the sheepfold another way, the scripture say you're like a thief and a robber because you're feeding them, you're feeding them 99% of the truth. What are doing for you? If I telling you everything, but I ain't telling you that the mark of the beast is the chip, I misleading you. I not looking out for you. So then what are doing to your lying? I ain't telling you the truth. Understand? This is Titus chapter 2 verse 8 and 9. It says No, Titus chapter 2 verse 8. It says sound speech. Sound speech. Sound speech that cannot be condemned. What the apostles, the elders, the teachers, the generals, the priests of great millstone is saying cannot be condemned. All the way down to the men and them who now come up but private, once you're sticking with this doctrine, it ain't gonna be condemned. That he that is of the contrary part, who is of the contrary part? These people out here in the world, they contrary to this truth, may be ashamed, having no evil thing to say of you. Because when that time reach, and they see wait that these men and them was really speaking truth, they gonna be ashamed. They ain't gonna have nothing evil to say against us. Once we stick with this thing. You understand? Once you stick with this, they can't say nothing. You can't say nothing. And that is a beautiful thing through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And I must say that. Hey, and brothers, pray for the Most High to have mercy upon you in them days, because them days right around the corner. Prophecies coming to pass as we speak. As I speak here right now, that prophecy is coming to pass with that whole Brexit situation. The mark of the beast being pushed like being pushed. Like everywhere you turn now, you're seeing this chip. And people don't believe that the mark of the beast is the chip. Them is some clown. So then where can I buy or sell it? If it's not the chip, why you can't buy or sell it? And the mark of the beast, the chip is used to buy and sell. Understand? So this whole thing, what we pushing through the spirit of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, is uncondemnable. It can't be condemned. In Acts chapter 5 verse 38, it says, and now I say, brethren, now I say unto you, Acts 5 and 38, now I say unto you, refrain from these men, and let them alone. For if this counsel or this work be of men, it will come to naught. I see Apostle Elataha, since in the 80s, and you're there till today, 2016. Possibly like a bar out there since the 90s, and you're there still today. Apostle La Ramlab out there since the 90s too, I believe, could be before, and you're there still today. Also Apostle La Roca. And now they're still today and they're teaching the same thing they was teaching back then. So if it was of men, it would have come to naught already. But it's not of men. But if it be of the Most High, you cannot overthrow. This work is of the Most High. Take care. Do so and come up with some new thing. It don't have no new thing. This is it. What a man teach, that is the doctrine the Most High. It has to have somebody. It have to have somebody to teach the truth on the earth, because we living in the last days. We living in the end. We living in the last few seconds of the so-called white man kingdom, which is Esau in the Bible. We living in that time. So if it is, we living in that time, it had to have somebody to come and teach you the truth. And that the men who the Most High set up over there in America, and the word reach all along in Trinidad here through the spirit of the Most High, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So it say, verse 39, but if it be of the Most High, Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai, ye cannot overthrow it. You can't come up with something new and try and overthrow what the men say. What we saying is the truth. Is either you take it or you leave it. Lest happily ye be found even to fight against the Most High. So that's what I'll be trying to do. If you're trying to come against it, you're fighting against the Most High, you're scoffing against the Most High, because Yahushua say, he that heareth you heareth me, and he that heareth me heareth him that sent me. So you're not fighting against we, you're fighting against the Most High, and that will be your own destruction. This is 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 8. It says, he therefore that despiseth not man. So if you're hating, if you're scoffing, you're talking shit against the men and them, because what? Is Ephesians 4? Let me just get that quick. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 5. It says there's one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one power. So if you come with our next power, if you're coming with Jesus, you're lying. If you're coming with Christ, you're lying. If you're coming with Jehovah, you're lying. It's our one God. One and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. So he says our one faith, one belief. So jumping back to 1 Thessalonians 4 and 8. He therefore that despiseth not man. So you're despising man. You despising that one faith, because it had two faith, that one scripture say one faith, one Lord, one baptism. So if you hating on the men and them who showing you the real way, you ain't really hating on them, but the scripture say, but the Most High, who hath also given unto us his Holy Spirit. So that is who you're hating. You ain't despising man, but you're despising God, Yahweh, the supreme Yahweh. That is who you're hating on. And you have to be a damn fool to be hating on the supreme Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai. And this is my last precept here. This is 1 John 2 and 21. It says, I have not written unto you because you know the truth, but because you know it. I have not written unto you because you know the truth. You know not the truth, but because you know it, and that no lie is of the truth. That no lie of the truth. That no lie of the truth. And through the Spirit of Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai, the apostle is a great millstone. Have the truth. It have no lie of it. It's 100% truth. And it's either you believe that, or if you believe some part along the line, whatever they say in the lying, but then something wrong with you. I don't believe the lying. I don't believe whatever they say the lying, because I look it up. I look for myself too. That's the thing. You have to look for yourself. You have to look for yourself to see, hey, prove it. Don't just take it and run with it. Prove what the men and them said. Because I watch countless videos and I prove what I said. And I could say that they ain't lying. They're literally actually telling you the truth about the whole situation what's going on the earth right now. And like I said before, Esau is the so-called white man. That's the truth. He's the wicked. He's Satan. He's the old serpent. Because the spirit was in he is that same spirit that was in the serpent who beguiled Eve. That same wicked spirit. The mark of the beast is the RFID microchip. That is the truth. America gonna be destroyed by thermonuclear destruction. That is the truth. That is not no, the scripture say it are no lie of the truth. And all these things written inside the Bible. But you have to have a spiritual eye to understand it. You can't just understand it just so. Two-thirds of Israel gonna be destroyed. All nations going and going to slavery under the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. That is the truth. Yahushua coming back in a big so-called UFO, a chariot. The chariots are Israel. That is the truth. What you have again? That many others. NATO and the EU. America going and split up with NATO. Because the scripture say that they go on the ten horns going on they go in just roughly paraphrasing, they're going on be divided and they're going on hate the horn maker desolate too. That is the truth. I say already 2/3 of Israel go and be destroyed. That is the truth. The kingdom of heaven is going on be set up on the earth. Yahweh Shai and Yahweh, the Heavenly Father and His Son, are dark-skinned men. The angels are dark-skinned men. We are the Israelites. That is the truth. According to the Bible. And that is just it. So you can't get around that. You can't get around that because it's written inside the Bible. The Latinos are Israelites too. Okay, that some clowns say that Israel is only Negroes. No. The Gentiles that could be saved are Israelites who lost their heritage back then and who coming back now into the truth. That is the Gentiles who could be saved. Gentiles that cannot be saved are heathens. That is why the apostles say the Gentiles versus the Gentiles. So that is the truth. And there is no way around it. If you didn't understand it, not because somebody didn't understand it, that don't mean you're off. Them just don't understand it. They didn't get the eye, they didn't have the mind to understand it. But you understand it. So that don't mean you're off. It's just they don't understand it. So I read it over again and close. 1 John chapter 2 verse 21. It says, I have not written unto you because ye know not the truth, but because ye know it, and that no lie, it have no lie of the truth, and that no lie is of the truth. So is either 100% truth or nothing at all. 99% truth is not the truth. And until the next time, I say, double honesty, the apostle, let us have a great millstone again. Barakatayahawa, Barakatayahawashai, Shalom.